It is my purpose today to lay before you certain points which the American delegation will advocate. One, the American government advocates consideration of the draft convention as containing the outline of a convenient basis for discussion, while expressing its entire willingness to give full consideration to any supplementary proposals calculated to advance the ends we all seek. Two, we suggest the possibility of prolonging the existing naval agreements concluded at Washington and London, and we advocate completing the latter as soon as possible by the adherence of France and Italy. Three, we advocate proportional reductions from the figures laid down in the Washington and London agreements on naval tonnage as soon as all parties to the Washington agreement have entered this framework. Four, we advocate, as we long have done, the total abolition of the submarine. Five, we will join in formulating the most effective measures to protect civilian populations against bombing from the air. Six, we advocate the total abolition of lethal gases and bacteriological warfare. The burden and dangers of the gigantic machinery of warfare, which are now being maintained in times of peace, have reached a point where they threaten civilization itself. The delegation of the United States is representing not only a government, but a people. And the mandate from both is in the same unmistakable terms, that decrease in arms is an essential, not alone to economic recovery of the world, but also to the preservation of the whole fabric of peace.